Hello, my dear friends. This is Shaman Garbhat here, and I'm continuing the series about the Flight Gear Flight Simulator. Today, a new aircraft. It's the Tupolev 95 MR. It was an old model in Flight Gear, and I have made a few hundred of add-ons to it. So full instrumentation, a lot of animations, and a lot of fun. So at the moment we see the Tupolev standing in Irkutsk. If you don't know where Irkutsk is, it's in Russia, on the banks of the Baikal River, Lake Baikal, very very big lake, and we are here in the airport of Irkutsk, and we are standing here on the field. And now we are going to prepare the aircraft. So you see the ground crew is standing around and waiting for something. So let's go into the aircraft. Drop, drop, drop. And first of all, put in the batteries, instrument lights on, and then the lights from the airplane. Then we activate the full system and start the first engine. So we see the first engine is starting up now. And we continue to start the next engine. And in the meantime, we activate all the electric instruments. Starting the two inner engines now. And they are coming up. So then we make the chokes away and put the leather in. So they are now in. And then we check the compass. The magnetic variation is 3.7 degree. 3.5, that's okay. Squawk. Squawk code also. And then we have prepared everything and we can loose the brake and go to the runway. It's a very big aircraft. And as you know, I like the Russian aircrafts, the old ones. And this is also today the fastest turboprop aircraft. It's about 850 kilometers per hour, which is really fast for a turboprop. It's not a jet engine, it's a propeller engine, double propellers. And the code name is Bear. So it's the Flying Bear. It's a long distance bomber. It is used actually in Syria in combination with the Tupolev 160. They're both long distance bomber. Now coming to the runway. And we have to use the complete runway for this aircraft. So we go to the starting point. And then we line up on the runway. Adjust our compass. And then we are ready for takeoff, setting two flaps. And waiting till the engines are coming up and then loosen the brake and let's go. This time I use the automatic vertical climbing. I put my climbing rate to 1500 or let's say 1600. And we can watch from outside. Now we go up. Now the front wheel is in the air. And now we are in the air. So putting the gears in. And loosening the flaps. For this flight we will go to the river Baikal, make a turn and go back to the airport. Or we may go to another airport. There is Irkutsk Northwest. We maybe go to this airport and land on this airport. So we go to the GPS map and look to the information. Okay, we see there is no information. It's a military airport. We have no information for this airport. We have only the some fixes, and no, there is nothing which we can use for landing there. So only visual approach is possible. But as you know, it's not a problem. So we will turn now to the, let's look to the Baikal first, to the river, to the lake. So we change our flight direction to the south now and go to the lake. So we put in here the 170 degree or something and activate the heading control. As all of my aircrafts, you can fly them completely in the cockpit without the joystick, and that's really amazing to make all the flight maneuvers completely with the instruments, which are all working. It's, everything is working, all the systems, 180 instruments, lamps and switches, the radio panel, the engineer panel, and now we see the lake in front of us. So let's hold the altitude. It's about 9,000 feet now, 8,900 feet. And information from this airport, UER, it's number 6. So we see the runway is 318 degree. So we put in the information 318 degree to the runway in our compass. 318 degree now, this is the runway. Now let's look from outside. We are approaching the Lake Baikal. 700 kilometers long lake, biggest lake in the world, with the most amount of sweet water. Okay, so let's turn around. Let's check on the map what our direction will be. It will be about 300 degrees. So let's go to 300. Speed at the moment is 700 kilometer per hour. It's very fast. And the ground speed. Ground speed and airspeed indicator. And here I have the Mach indicator. Mach 0.6. We check the wind and the QNH. We have no QNH here, we have an QFE 714. It's different to America. 714. You see this in the Russian aviation, we have different measures, and I have to scroll a long time to get to 714. And that's now the QNH from the runway. So we have now the altitude, it's 8300 now from the runway, 2600 meters. So I activate the altitude again. My flight direction is now 300 degrees, and that's not what I want. I want to go in this direction now. So that's north, that's 360. This aircraft a lot. The sound is beautiful, the shape is beautiful, and the performance is also really nice. It can fly in 47,000 feet, which is more than 10,000 feet above the normal air passenger flights. It's really high up in the air. And very, very fast. So it can go in one way from Russia to USA and back, and make the missions. Or today in Syria, they're coming from Russia and flying to Syria and going back to Russia. Let's hope that the situation in Korea will cool down a little bit. Nobody needs a war. Only the crazy people in the world who want to sell their weapons and all the stuff. Of course they need war every day. But the normal people do not need the war. So now we are flying directly over the airport from Irkutsk, and it's time to go down with the speed and with the altitude. So I set my speed now to 280 and my altitude to 6000 feet. And let's look from outside. We are approaching the Irkutsk airport. Then make a left turn and fly to the airport, which is here in this region. So for the fun of the day, we shut down two engines on the right. So you see now two engines are out. The two engines are out. They are not powered anymore. And we have only these two engines running now. And we make emergency landing in Irkutsk, northwest. So we are reducing the speed to 220. And the altitude to 5000, yeah, 4000 is now the altitude above the ground, so I can reduce it to 3000, because we have set the altimeters to the runway Queen H, so the altitude is now measured not in the normal altitude, it's the ground altitude from the ground. Now we see that we need to change our flight direction to the airport. We have missed it a little bit, so I go a little bit more than the heading from the runway. Maybe 30 degrees more, so that's fine now. Oh, I see the airport, so we are really near. Maybe 30 degrees too less, I go to 90 degrees now. And my descent rate should be much more. So I'm putting a descent rate of 3000 for the moment. Checking my speed to 180, setting two flaps. Oh, there is a pilot coming up in the multiplayer. It's a good friend and helped a lot developing all these aircrafts. So for the moment I give him a message. about deactivating the autopilot, gears out, and approaching the runway with two engines only running. Looks okay, it's no problem at all. So the only problem is the braking now, because I have only two engines running. So I need the hard brakes. And I not managed to land exactly, and we crashed. So that's happening sometimes. We crashed now. Bad, bad, bad. So I hope you like this video in any case, and see you next time. Bye bye.